Hello, my name is Lata Brouwer and you are watching Violin Lounge TV. After over 250 episodes in which I mainly give you some instructions, which are quite general, I have decided to change Violin Lounge TV around a little bit. And I do that by video exchange. This will help you even better because viewers are sending me in their videos and then I answer their questions and give them feedback. One of the first was Frances, and she asked me a question about Brahms' Lullaby. She writes, I'm a violin beginner for 6.5 months now, so being relatively new, I am aware that all aspects of my playing still need some more work to keep on improving. My question is this, what is the worst bad habit that you can see in my playing right now that you think I should correct first? Because I know there are many. And if you have any suggestions on how I should practice this, that would be great. Regards, Frances, she says also, thank you for your generous support and sharing your gift of teaching and playing. Well, here is Frances' video. Thanks so much, Frances, for sending in your video. I know it requires some courage to just post your video online and wait for the feedback. And on behalf of the other viewers, I would like to thank you because this video will not only be useful for you, but also for other viewers. Well, the first thing I would like to notice is that you wrote that you started on an E, but actually you start on an F with the second finger on the D string. It might be easier because here and there you're mixing up some notes, so it might be a little bit easier for you to start with the first finger. So to really start on the E, first finger on the D string, and to use low second finger, so actually the second finger frame, throughout the piece. So then your second finger is close to your first finger. Well, you mainly asked me about responding to some bad habits. Well, I will first go into some general things about your playing, and after that I'm going into some specifics about this piece. If you want the sheet music of this piece, you can find a link below that leads to the sheet music that I recommend. Only I would like to add some bowings to that, which makes it easier for you and also makes it, makes it more beautiful sounding actually. But as promised, first I'll go into some general things about your playing. Well, what you want with this lullaby is that people can fall asleep on it. It's a cradle song and you want it to sound very fluent and very quiet. Well, fluent bowing is the way to achieve that. You do that by getting more fluency and movement in your wrist and fingers, more like this, like swimming jellyfish actually, and by moving actually your upper arm a little bit less. So sometimes when you're bowing, I see a little bit this. This is actually fighting, and this is bowing. So if you bow on open strings in front of the mirror, perhaps as an exercise, make sure that your upper arm is almost not moving, except when you are going to the extreme frog, you do a little bit this, but normally in bowing you don't do this. So that's the upper arm. I have some videos on fluent bowing and on getting the movement in your wrist and fingers. That's very important because your hold, your violin hold and bow hold actually look quite okay. Your bow hold is good. Now try to not make it a static hold, but really try to make it a fluent movement. So your bow hold is more like a bow movement, something dynamic and not something fixed. And certainly in the beginning, people tend to, when they have achieved a good bow hold, they tend to, yay, I've got a bow hold, now I've got it, and I'm going to hold it forever. So that's not really affecting your tone in a positive way. So try to do the fluency in your wrist and fingers. So when you do up bow, your wrist goes up and your wrist goes down on the down bow. And on the up bow, your fingers bend, and on the down bow, your fingers stretch. That's just in general, but I'll link to some specific videos on that below. Then the last tip I would like to give you in general is use more bow. That also makes it more fluent. That actually makes the difference between if you do this, etc., or so that will already improve your song quite a bit. Then now I'm going to into some specifics about this song, but these are the things you generally need to work on. Also the intonation, but I recommend another fingering, so starting on the E, on the first finger with this piece. So it will change around a little bit, and it might be even easier for you to play it in tune. So what you need to do is, in general, slur all the eighth notes in this piece. Actually, if you want good bowings for this piece, to which I link to the sheet music below, now slur all the eighth notes. And if you are in, not the last bar, but the bar before, then you slur the E and the D. So the second and the third note, those are in the first bar of the last line in the sheet music. You slur them too, so you end up down bow in the end of the piece. Well, then you might wonder, if you are beginning, how do you need to slur two of the same notes, like we have the first note. And then what you do, don't think it too much, think about it too much actually. Just stop your bow, and then you actually slur them. So it's up, up, down. And that's actually how you play it. And then we end the piece on slurries and then a long note. So these are the bowings with this piece. People tend to play a lullaby very soft, because you can't fall asleep if someone's playing very loud. But on the other hand, don't fall into the trap of using too little bow. So you get a nice, light, transparent, airy sound if you use a lot of bow, but you hardly use pressure on your bow. So you're not pushing the bow with your index finger. Whether you're using weight or pressure, people know that I talk about weight versus pressure a lot. If you are wondering, what are you talking about, weight and weight versus pressure, then just take a look at finallylounge.com, where you can follow this free workshop about it. Completely free, but I'm not going too much into that at the moment. So what you want to have is this light sound, so not or too careful, but you want to have it have free bowing, and you can still do that softly. So that's the idea that you have to have with this piece. I hope this video is helpful to you. If you want to see more videos, go to violinlounge.com. There are over 250 completely free videos that you can watch, and that will certainly help you improve your violin playing. I wish you happy practicing and beautiful playing. See you in the next video. Bye!